how we view the markets with respect to asset classes? Not really. I think the market's telling us today this is more than a satisfactory result. It was anticipated. The bond market, I think a lot of investors might not be paying as much attention to the bond market, which is having a nice little reaction today. And so, but it doesn't really change our capital allocation decision. The sectoral impact's a different story.
Steve, same question to you.
We had three things we were worried about coming into this, Melissa. One was the election, the second is the Fed, and the third is the trade war. And we've got one of them out of the way. On the election, you know, on the one side, I put a piece on Federated's website today called Goldilocks, Political Goldilocks. And, you know, the two tail risks that the market was worrying about was, one, a blue wave that would have threatened the pro-growth agenda of the Trump administration, the tax cuts and the deregulation. On the other side of it, a red wave that would have potentially led to additional deficits and, you know, problems on debt slash interest rates. The bond market, as Lou mentioned, is actually rallying today. That's good for stocks. And the pro-growth agenda looks like it's in place. So, yeah, it looks like political gridlock here. Very unlikely. We saw the press conference. We're probably not going to see a lot of cooperation. That's probably good. From a policy perspective, ironically, right now. So we just got to get past, you know, the trade thing and the Fed. And, you know, those are still out there. But we think they're going to get resolved positively.
Those are pretty good things there, Steve. Those are pretty big things, aren't they? Well, they could be. I mean, who really knows? So, Leo, you mentioned this a moment ago, as we have a 410-point rally, 427 points now on the Dow. Very strong rally here. You said that sectoral positioning is a different matter rather than asset allocation. Explain what you were driving at there.
Yeah, I think we're in a broadly an equity-friendly investing environment. So we haven't changed our overall market forecast, 2,800 to 2,900 by year-end this year, 3,100 next year. With respect to the sector mix, I think investors are going to want to be sectorally diversified. And what we're seeing today is a return to...
And that means what?
I think we're... As we weed through sort of the sector results, you're seeing today a return to the growth-oriented sectors.
Yeah, in a big way.
If there's a positive surprise on the infrastructure side, energy, materials, industrial stocks have severely underperformed, and I think investors need to be prepared there as well. We're concerned about the financial sector, given the change in leadership at the committee level in the House. But generally, we think the interest-sensitive sectors which have underperformed are probably going to be performing a bit better in the next 12 to 18 months.
It sounds, Leo, almost like you want to be invested in value, but you're not really sure how everything's going to shake out. So you also want exposure to growth.
Because remember, growth stocks are sensitive to rate structure. And I do think this election gives us a pause
in the
bond bear market, right? I still think bond yields grind higher, but maybe not to the extent that it's going to severely punish growth stocks.
Leo, how should I be investing now with the results in?
Steve?
Oh, excuse me.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, sorry, Melissa. Yeah, we think the market looks pretty broad here. We like a lot of sectors. I agree with Leo on the growth side. You know, a lot of those stocks have been deeply oversold, and they're rallying today in a relief, as well as the healthcare. Within healthcare, we like the biotechs. But we really think, you know, the area of the market that has been really held back here that probably still has more room is the cyclical side. Within tech, even like the semi-cap equipment names, energy stocks are really still pretty depressed. We think they could have a nice bounce, and certainly on the industrial side. So there's something for everyone, I think, right now in the market, which is one reason why we're reasonably optimistic. Although, as Tyler mentioned, we still have some big hurdles in front of us.